Okay, next up is Crank High Voltage. And obviously, the first Crank wasn't bad enough, so hey, they had to just outdo it by making a movie much worse than its predecessor. Yes, Chev Chelios is back, and Jason Statham is back in that role. And we thought he was dead, but he's not! And guess what? A nearly indestructible heart has been built for him, but a Chinese mobster has stolen it. Ooh. So he now has to rely on a battery-powered heart to keep and to keep himself charged up. Now you're thinking this has the means for plot line of a comedy. Well, they actually try to be comedic in some scenes in this film, and they fail miserably. To me, it just comes off as weird and very unnerving at times. And again, I'm starting to sound like a broken record, but an action movie can be on the beyond the realm of rationality and realism, but it shouldn't look like that's what it's doing. Remember, I used Speed as a prime example. I turned my brain off, I watched this, and was not impressed at all. Now, much like the atrocity known as 12 Rounds, this wasn't screened for critics, but I still saw it anyway. And this makes 12 Rounds pretty much look like Face Off. To quote Roger Ebert, I hated, 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 hated this movie. Ugh, this is just one giant fuster-cluck of nauseatingly obnoxious so-called entertainment that's supposed to be okay because, oh hey, it's an action film. I'm not expecting an Oscar film here, but come on, give me at least something to work with. A lot of the comedic bits in this movie, including Statham practically having softcore porn sex with his lady friend, played by Amy Smart, or violating some old lady, come off as a terribly done mad TV skit, or even worse, make the stuff that Stuttering John did on the old Howard Stern TV show seem like comedic brilliance on the level of Eddie Murphy in Delirious. Now, I know this movie is trying to be over the top, but rather than enjoy it, I felt it was ridiculous. One minute this is an over-the-top action comedy, the next it's a very serious action film with serious rivalries and shootouts and whatever. Look, Jason Statham is very, very good at what he does. I enjoyed some of the Transporter movies, and I really liked him a lot in The Bank Job. He brings a natural charisma and energy and looks like a guy you don't want to mess with. He looks like an action hero. But I find it hard to enjoy this bad dude acting like the Flasher in Observe and Report. If you're going to put Statham in an action comedy, and again, that's assuming what this is, because I really don't know what this is. They're going in one direction and then the other, I don't know. If you're gonna put him in an action comedy, put him together with either Nicolas Cage or Eddie Murphy, because goodness knows they could use a revival as well. And have a good script with smart, fresh, and peppy dialogue, along with some awesome, fun action scenes. As terrible as this movie was, it won't hurt Statham. I believe he'll be a big action star for many years to come, because again, he's just very good at it. Also, nice to see Corey Haim working again, sporting a mullet in this film and looking a lot like Dog the Bounty Hunter on Jenny Craig. But he's completely wasted here, as are David Carradine and Dwight Yoakam. For having to sit through this, I think I deserve an award. No, really, I think I deserve like a plaque or something, because I'm sure for the few critics who did see this movie, I'm probably one of the few that didn't walk out. I deserve to have my own private Hawaiian island, be married to Avril Lavigne or Megan Fox, and have an unlimited supply of McDonald's as well as Pop-Tarts. And write a law where there's no more crank movies at all. That is the award I should get for this. As a matter of fact, I even want more than that. I want an unlimited supply of gold bars. I want an unlimited supply of money. That's what I should get for having to sit through this crap. Beyond terrible. Zero. That's right, getting the big fat zero out of five.